Hello, everybody. It's time for Xbox to bring us home and finish this E3 Key 3. I have no idea what to expect. Well, actually, I have a few things I know. I think everybody knows Persona 3 is coming out. Everybody knows that. And then Persona 5 Tactica. A lot of people are saying Gears and Fable will show up in some capacity.
Mm.
So, got those to look forward to, I guess.
Fable would have me so happy.
They were hard teasing Fable, so I think Fable will show up. I just don't know if it's like the new Fable that they've been working on for like 8 years, or if they're just gonna do like a remaster.
Yeah, because I'd be happy with either one of those, because I found out that Susie has never played a Fable game.
Oh, really?
Nope.
And I was like, oh, well, let's get a Fable game and play it together, and realize it's borderline impossible. It's just not a thing. I can't buy a Fable game on PC to play with her.
I could have swore the original was up on PC. Am I wrong?
I think Fable 1 is single player, though, right?
Oh, yeah, there's no multiplayer to that.
I should have. 2 and 3 are the only ones I've ever played. But I was so bummed.
I've only played
2,
so.
I mean, 3, I think, is regarded as worse than 2, but I thoroughly enjoyed both of them.
I wanted to play Fable 3. I think I started, but I didn't have access to the game. Like, it was at my dad's house. I didn't go there very often, so.
That's
like,
fair.
I started it, and like I never actually got around to finishing it.
I walked all the way down here thinking I'll get a drink, remembered I'm out of sodas. I know, I might do a quick grocery order.
That's fair. Ooh, maybe
more soda.
Baguettes.
You need baguettes?
That would be nice. I would like some baguettes.
Oh, I could probably make you guys bigger on the screen. Hold on. There you go.
Matt, you played Monster Hunter World Iceborne, right?
Yep.
I just fired it up, and I'm so happy, because I think I've complained about this before, but I loved Monster Hunter Rise, and I put a good amount of time into World. My biggest complaint is that I can't fucking pause World, and I just found like a GitHub app that's like pretty seamless and just lets me pause World whenever I want using the pause button on the keyboard, and I'm so happy. I can actually play this game and have a life with multiple dogs that need attention.
Nah, it's fine. I mean, if you got to the point where I was and you were doing hunts in like 10 minutes.
Like, so that's where I was with the base game, and then I fired up Iceborne like a year ago and did the first mission, and it got so fucking stomped that I was prepared for the level cap difference. It's like, I don't have time to be able to do this 40 minutes without pausing. But now I can pause. I'm happy.
What did you use?
I am trying to remember so much about this game right now. I fired it up like 2 minutes ago. I am using the dual blades, though, it looks like.
Okay.
I think that is predominantly what I've used in this. It's what I used in Rise, too. Man, I put like 100 hours into Rise, though. I loved that. I think it was predominantly because I could pick it up and pause it whenever I wanted. It worked so well for me.
I mean, yeah, that works. I played a fair amount of Rise. I got to the end of the base game, but then, like, right around that time, I started getting FF14,
fair.
Which has replaced my Monster Hunter. Because Monster Hunter used to be, I would just, you know, load up Monster Hunter whenever I had time and just put time into that. But now that's just being taken up by FF14, so I just have not gotten back into it.
That's reasonable.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm gonna see if I can remember how to play this game at all. I'm getting my ass handed to me. It's gonna be glorious.
Nice.
Did you
see that they accidentally leaked the length of this thing too?
Oh really? How long is it supposed to be?
It's like 2 hours. Like a little under.
Okay. Excuse me.
Now I assume the last half hour will be Starfield, because that's typically what Bethesda does with their big title. As they just throw it, like, they do a big, dumb gameplay showcase right at the end. Is anybody excited about Starfield?
No, I love space games so much, but AAA releases have been so disappointing to me for the last year that I would rather be like planned to be disappointed and be pleasantly surprised at this point.
That's fair.
It's like I can't think of a single, there's probably one or two AAA releases in the last year I played that I was like, yeah, that met my expectations. Like, where Susie and I are still playing through Ragnarok right now, and I'm loving that. I mean, it's long.
Right, yeah, Ragnarok is long, but there's definitely points where you can feel that this was originally supposed to be a trilogy that they just kind of dumped into two games.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're, I feel like we're past the halfway mark, but we're just, because we play it when we both have some time, so we're just getting through it very slowly.
Yeah. I mean, I enjoyed it. It's just
this concept.
Time? Yeah, who has any of that, really?
I do, because I just used my pause button in Monster Hunter to have that conversation.
Sick.
I forgot to eat, fuck.
Oh, no. Oh, you don't want to do that.
Time.
I forget, does Rise have food available? I remember that World did.
Yeah, Rise has, I'm going to mispronounce, mochi.
The mochi? Is there a person, like, at base camp who makes mochi?
I think there's a fire there, and you can kind of whip some stuff together, but I don't think there's a person there.
Yeah, because I remember that the handler in World, like, if you forgot to eat, you could just eat right there, but it wasn't, like, you only had, like, set choices. You couldn't make your own meal.
Yeah. I was like, I think the things I liked the most about Rise were like how easy it was to zip around for like traversal of the map and run around on your dog.
Yeah, I mean, I really liked the spider wire that you got to play around with.
I had so much fun with it.
The wire bug, that's it. That's the name.
I'm still salty that when they ported it to PC, they didn't give you cross save, because I would have easily bought that game again, but
yeah,
this is not...
I had a bunch of people who were playing it on PC, and it's like, oh, but I don't want to buy it again and redo all of the progress
is,
I made.
I am okay with certain grindy games to an extent. I will never be down to grind through a game like this twice. Because
yeah.
So much of it is padding.
Yeah, a lot of it is go fight monsters again so you
and
can
like
get gear that's actually capable of not getting you killed.
It helps that they have like a decent loop and the gameplay is fantastic, but I don't care how good it is, I'm not doing it twice. I'm not dumping 100 hours into the same game two times over.
Yeah. Nah, I agree.
I think I've said this before, but as I've gotten older, I have really appreciated short, concise games where it's like, where it works. I'm okay with, like, the other extreme, too, if it's, like, a Monster Hunter and it's like, that's part of the mechanics, but so many games now just try to pad out time to, like, it's a 40-hour game when it could be, like, a great 10-hour game.
I don't want to talk about FF7 remake.
Like, if it manages to be good all throughout that, that's fantastic. It's more often than not, I am tired of a game by the time it's over, and I wish it finished, and I still want a little bit more, like finding that sweet spot.
Yeah, FF7 remake is way too long, because I remember looking at the dev interviews, because like that the first remake game is literally the first quarter of the game of of the original base game that they just went in there and made 40 hours. So they found, so there was like 10 hours in there, like originally, and they put 30 hours of other stuff for you to do.
The only game I've ever found that actually I think did a remake well was fucking Wind Waker HD, because they shortened the most annoying part of the game.
So I did hear that, is that the remaster is better than like playing the GameCube version.
Oh, good. They also, yeah, they actually shortened it in two ways. So they actually cut out half of a quest line that you had to do, where it was a fetch quest. They just were like, nah, you only have to fetch three things now, not seven. And then they also gave you a sail that was twice as fast as the original sail.
Oh, nice.
So you just could zoom between islands. It was so wonderful. And the fact that they haven't fucking re-released it on the Switch.
I'm shocked they haven't, because I know they already have it up on... it's like one of the very few holdouts from the Wii U that hasn't been ported up to Switch yet.
I know! It's like, just kick it over there, please!
Wherever that Google Excel spreadsheet is that just has all of the like Wii U exclusives that have been ported now to Switch.
I feel like at this point they're just waiting for something bad to happen. Like a fire or something destroys all the games they currently have in development, and then they're like,
supposedly they had the Metroid Prime remaster was sitting around for like a year. Supposedly, before they actually released it, so that's entirely possible that they do have that. It's just sitting until they have like a gap in their schedule. Frankly, I wouldn't be surprised. I would not be surprised if it actually just showed up at whenever Nintendo does their E3 thing this year. Supposedly July is what I've heard.
Yeah, they tend to do later. Like, midsummer, not early summer like most people, because they want to generate hype for the holidays.
Well, I mean, when there was E3, they would do it during the convention week. They would do it on, like, the Tuesday, and they were always the last big publisher to put a little thing together.
Oh, Matt, I'm sorry, this is off topic. Real quick, is it you pay with money or you pay with points in Monster Hunter? Which one's the useless one that you use for food?
Points, for the most part, I remember being kind of useless. Yeah. Money you still needed to buy weapons. I don't remember that points really did anything, so a lot of times I pay with points.
Yeah, I knew it was one was useless and the other you want to save for useful stuff, and I always mix it up and spend it all on food.
Yeah, I mean, spending it on food is a good idea, though.
I do
need food.
God, I forgot how good the food animations were in this game.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now I'm so hungry. Why did I do this?
Oh, no. I mean, luckily for me, I ate before this, so I'm not that hungry. Until we see what we're going to be eating from Xbox.
Oh, yeah, I need to pull up the stream. What am I doing here?
Well, hey, I was going to say.
It's
9.
Twitch the best one?
Twitch is the best one that I've seen, usually.
Yeah, usually Twitch has the least amount of lag.
Yeah. And then YouTube, it's actually like a premiere. It's just a video on YouTube, if I remember correctly. Xbox Game Studio presents...
Oh, we're finally doing this, are we? Because I was going to make a sandwich.
Is this Fable? This is Fable.
Okay. Let's do it. What do I think about heroes?
Also, it's that dude from IT Crowd. About the place.
With their disproportionately high cheekbones and comically massive weapons. Wanker. Roughing up bandits, because they like to rough up bandits, don't they? Living it up with the common folk every single night. On a day-to-day basis, I'd say the true hero's me, someone who's breaking new ground with fruit, with veg, on the agricultural side of things. Just look at them. Not wafting around mythical creatures. And that's what they are. Wafters.
Yeah, well done.
You see, I'm not here to slay legendary beasts. I'm here to conquer the vegetable, not a euphemism. Let's face it, the age of heroes is over. This is the age of innovation. This, if you will, is the age of death. One moment.
What I'm getting is no gameplay.
This is awkward.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go, Luke. Fable right away.
I'm excited, but I really wish it was gameplay after waiting like 4 years since the last reveal.
Yeah, I was gonna say, there's not much here. There's not much to chew on. They'd been teasing that something would be here, so it's not like that's that shocking.
Please, please cut to gameplay.
No, now you get a different world premiere.
No, no, tell me this is the world premiere for the gameplay. World premiere for gameplay, right? Right?
Only. In-engine footage.
God damn it. That was, fuck you.
I don't even think they showed a thing saying in-engine footage for the Fable thing at all.
God.
Oh, we got a wonky frame rate. Avowed. We're bringing back Obsidian's little Skyrim. Oh, I just remembered I should probably mute the stream for a second. This is probably copyrighted to shit. Who are we revealing? I feel like I'm supposed to know this person, but I don't.
Big people are the theme of this showcase.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't think they're a real-life person. I feel like I'm supposed to know who the character is. And I don't know.
Yeah, there was a bit of a build-up to the face reveal that was making me think I was going to recognize.
It's a black person!
Holy shit! No way! South of Midnight. I mean, that looks interesting, I guess. Not that we really saw much of it.
At least it feels like it had character, which is more than can be said for a lot of games recently.
That is true.
At this point, I just want people to try different things and be creative. If it doesn't work, at least you tried.
I really like that they were working with, like, frame rate switches.
Yeah!
Like. That's always really neat to see. That's what I hear. Ubisoft Star Wars?
They're everywhere. Speaking of Solus. But the world here
belongs to the syndicates. If this is more CG, I'm gonna fucking scream. I have to play their game. Is this just gonna be all CGs in this thing?
Really, really hoping that wouldn't be the case.
I would really like to see some, you know, gameplay. My headphones. My headphones are being angry at me, so I need to switch my battery out. Alright.
I like the cute axolotl thing.
Oh, you know, it's Disney, so they have to have something marketable.
They have to have something they can turn into a plushie.
It's
that goobers like me can buy.
Hilarious how, like, everything they release, you could tell, like, this was the one they designed for the merchandise.
Yeah. Where's my Ubisoft tower, goddammit? I want to see the Ubisoft towers I'm going to be climbing for most of the first game.
Yeah.
Okay, if this is what, like, in-game cutscenes look like, like an animated Star Wars tale like that, that's not just like forced to be another like Skywalker saga, but like its own story in the universe, would be really cool.
Yeah.
That I would be here for.
No, this is Luke Skywars' 13th cousin removed once.
It's just probably like everything they do has to be tied to the main trilogy and can't be anywhere else in the universe. Because fuck you.
Alright, cool.
It's always been my headcanon that Willow is part of the Star Wars universe.
Oh, there's an Ubi Forward tomorrow? Oh, well, I'm not
there's
probably going to watch that.
There's a PC Direct, I think, at 4 today, too.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, there is. Welcome to our a lot of those smaller ones I usually don't watch, though. Xbox Game
Showcase, yeah, I'm going to miss the PC one.
Xbox, I thought you learned your lesson about having people introduce trailers.
Gaming. Okay, so we're getting the star. Good call.
Listen, at least this time we're getting a woman.
I thought we had one last year. Maybe it was 2 years ago.
No, at the one we did a couple of days ago.
Oh,
there was
oh,
no women.
Jeff
not Keighley. A single one.
Not a. Oh no, you're right. There was not a single one.
And it was just kind of like, I shouldn't be surprised by the sexism, but somehow.
Well, to be fair, it was mostly Jeff Keighley. It was mostly just one dude. For you today is just incredible. So long as they don't wheel out Aisha Tyler to try and make memes again, I'm good. We made this show for you, the largest, most engaged, and globally diverse fan base in Xbox history. You are the heart and soul of Xbox. You're man, listen to the triumphant music.
This is way too cheesy.
I know.
This is undeservedly, like, we don't need this much cheese.
I know. I feel like I'm swimming in a plate of nachos.
This next now I want nachos. Lotus,
the award-winning studio behind Spiritfarer. Who've gone back to their combat roots. Wait, is this
ooh, I should get pepperjack cheese and make us nacho cheese.
Oh, this music is coming from the showcase? I thought that was right, Monster everybody. Hunter music.
No.
They're not curing world hunger here.
Right.
Yeah, it's the Xbox showcase.
But it's the world premiere of...
something from the studio
oh,
Thunder
hey,
Lotus.
Here we go. I assume this is the sequel to Hades.
Yeah.
No, it's a different, different
dev.
Oh,
didn't they already announce the sequel to Hades?
Yeah, I just didn't think we saw gameplay for it yet.
We did not.
It does look just like Hades.
Which always makes me a little concerned. Like, doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad thing, but it could also mean like, let's copy this art style and sell it.
Yeah.
God, when did I become a cynic? No, I'm sorry. This looks great. I like this art style. These people did good.
I don't know.
Good for
it's,
you guys.
It's similar, but it's more simple.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does have its own little flair to it.
Yeah.
It isn't... I feel like with the Hades, it was almost like,
what?
I'm sorry, did that say 30-person co-op?
Sick.
Man, I don't even know 30 people who are alive.
You know what? I've been complaining a lot about how all these games are like 3 and 4 player co-op, and we always alienate someone in our group when we want to play a game together, so I'm here for it.
Yeah, this is fun. Alright, Xbox. Give me 33 fucking friends to play with.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think if I have 33 gamer friends.
33 immortals.
Okay. All
so
right.
Does the name change if you have less friends?
Yes.
32.
One immortal.
One sad immortal.
Yeah. One lonely bastard.
One lonely bastard. All
right, guys. Oh, hey, Payday 3.
Hey, the Payday 2 is free right now on Epic. Nothing to for anyone that wants it.
I think I already own it, and also I think I picked it up.
Hit the floor.
Man, I've always kind of liked Payday, but I can never, like, I was always got late to Payday, so I never really had a group of people to do it with.
Yeah, I know this isn't, like, probably true for it, but every time I tried to play, it just felt like Horde Simulator. And I know there's more to it, but I just never really got to see it.
Yeah.
God damn it, I'm being cynical again. I mean, yeah, no, it was a really cool concept.
Nah, it's fine.
When did you get bitter, honey?
I don't know. I realized this when we had that team building thing at work.
Yeah, that's where you realize it, eh?
I was just shit-talking everything next to this poor little intern that's just getting to see the world. I was like, oh my god, no.
I mean, this looks like gameplay, which is... Well, we're 15 minutes in, they finally showed gameplay of something.
Did you have the option in Payday 2 to do a completely stealth heist?
I don't know.
Because that would be cool. But it felt very geared towards, like, this is just the shooter, and the premise is you're in a bank.
I mean, maybe. Oh, here it is. Here's the Persona 3 remake trailer that leaked, like, 2 days early.
As long as they don't give me Persona 5 spoilers or 4, because I'm in the middle of playing it.
Well, this is 3, which has nothing to do with 4 or 5.
That's right, they're all standalone, aren't they?
Yeah, they're all very much standalones. God damn it, Persona music, why are you so good?
Yeah. Persona is one of the rare games that it's like 123 hours and I'm still like enjoying playing through it.
Hmm. The one thing that I want to know about this remake, though, is are they going to have the expansion that came with FES?
I feel like you got to do the expansion, right?
I mean, that's probably the biggest reason why 3 was in desperate need of a remake, because there's no definitive version of it.
Because that was what Persona 4 Royale, whatever the one I'm playing is, did. They combined, like, everything
Golden?
Into one. Yeah.
Golden, this 4.
Am I... God, I don't know if I'm actually playing through...
And then Persona 5 has Royal.
Okay, no, that's the one I'm doing. Okay, yeah.
And then Persona 3 has the base game, and then there was like a quote-unquote definitive version that came out on PS2 called FES that had that little extra bit. And then they made a portable version that took out that expansion for some reason, but put in a female main character that you can switch in.
Interesting.
You can just play entirely from a female perspective.
The females.
Yeah. Yeah, you can date a boy.
Oh.
In a Persona game, it's crazy. And I guess there's actually some pretty significant changes to the story.
That's impressive.
Yeah.
I was just teasing, because every time I hear someone say females, it makes me think of the aliens from Star Trek.
Which ones?
Their name popped out of my head. The Ferengi. There it is.
Oh, the Ferengi? Oh, God.
Because they don't say men or women, they say males and females.
Oh, is this Avowed?
I think it's Avowed.
That'd be cool.
It looks very pretty.
I was just gonna say, I do like the art style.
I have been having like a bit of a problem with Obsidian lately in their combat, not feeling like, I don't know, like it's
yeah,
not sinking its
cynical.
Teeth in.
You're being cynical.
I know, but we just played Grounded.
I know we did just play Grounded, and honestly, I mean, the fact that it's Obsidian and I just shat so hard on Grounded when we were playing it, I don't know if I could bring myself.
Yeah, that's
I think
fair.
What's sad about Grounded is in the beta and the early access, it was great. And then they attempted to balance it, in quotes. And that balancing actively ruined the game. Because you no longer felt like you had any like effect on the environment.
Obsidian does know how to make like a pretty world.
Yeah, they're very good, except for gameplay sometimes is lacking.
Ooh.
Right, Rare and Lucasfilm.
Rare and Lucasfilm?
Oh, it's Sea of Thieves.
Oh, Sea of Thieves.
Yeah.
I thought
we were getting something new.
I know, me too. I was excited for a second. I was like, Conker's Bad Fur Day in space or something.
Oh, I would be hype about it.
I need to play Sea of Thieves again.
Oh, Monkey Island.
Oh! Okay. Oh wait,
not even Star Wars.
Maybe that'll get Maki to play. He likes Monkey Island, right?
Remember.
So tell me, which ship is right for you? A big ship? A luxury ship? A ship with just a splash of je ne sais quoi?
The legend of Monkey Island? You mean Governor Guybrush. But Freeport's not set foot out of that mansion for almost a year.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I told you no autographs. Though I see you have a meet and greet ticket. And I guess it's not every day that you get to meet the mighty pirate Guybrush Threepwood. The legend of Monkey Island.
LeChuck has turned the memories of this island. Yeah, I might play this. I like their more focus on story they've been pushing lately.
I think it's cool that they're bringing back Monkey Island so hard.
Yeah.
Oh, did that one? Did that new Monkey Island come out? I don't remember.
I think they had a remaster lately, but that was the last I saw.
Oh, maybe it was a remaster.
I do wish the melee combat had a little more depth in this game, though.
Hmm. I don't know. I feel like it's hard to do, like, first-person melee combat.
Yeah! That's the theme. Like, a grounded, Sea of Thieves that I run into a lot, like even like Skyrim and stuff, it's hard to find a way to make that feel like weighty and satisfying. Yeah. Without it just like swing sword.
Yeah, because even like Avowed, I was like, that just looks exactly like Skyrim's combat.
I genuinely don't know how you do it, so I can't really.
Wait, a Sobo?
Like a parry would be nice at least.
Isn't the Sobo the people that make the PlayStation, what is his name?
Oh, I think it's a flight simulator.
Oh, yeah, this is
an
flight simulator. Yeah, for you to fight fires, looks like.
Oh, that's actually kind of cool.
Yeah, it's pretty
this
neat.
This is one of those
expansion.
Things that's so niche, I can't even, like, attempt to shit on it, because I don't know if this is any good or not.
Yeah.
I don't know if this is exciting.
Not even close.
The fucking
get him.
For all I know, this is absolutely fantastic and amazing, yeah. And that we've all been waiting for this.
Credit to Microsoft compared to Sony right now is all of these games look like in their own right that they're good and like interesting.
Hmm. Mountain
Sony
Rescue
fell pretty flat for me.
This does look kind of neat, where they now have a bunch of different, like, styles of flying. You're not just randomly flying around.
Yeah, I have some friends that do, what's that one, like, hardcore flight sim, like DCM or something like that. They love this kind of shit.
Air racing, oh, yo. Okay, that sounds pretty sick.
Ooh, that flying through like a storm would be fucking awesome.
Oh yeah. Hot air balloon! Yeah! The thing we've all been waiting for on a Microsoft Flight Sim. Oh, is that like a new game? It said 2024.
Everything they've been doing has been an expansion, so that would be my best guess.
Oh, okay then maybe.
Like, just building on the platform.
Oh, it's Dune.
Ooh, are we getting the,
Oh, you get the Ornithopter in Microsoft Flight Sim.
That's funny.
Part 2 comes out soon, doesn't it?
I think the end of this year.
Yeah.
Do you get to see a sandworm?
That would be cool.
They didn't show one. It sucks.
Zero
I wanted that
ten,
tease
no
out of my flight sim. I want more sandworms in my flight sim.
It's in early access right now, but the Dune strategy game is actually really fun.
Oh, that's like early access and you can play it?
Yeah.
Oh. I did not know that.
It might be an Epic timed exclusive. I can't
remember. Oh, maybe. Also, Senua Hellblade 2 is back.
Simply play the first one.
Yeah, I didn't play. I heard it was kind of meh.
A unique perspective on the world. That's unfortunate.
Like the puzzling was really not very good. The combat was kind of clunky. Captured by the team on Xbox Series X. Mmm, yummy. Ninja Theory. So in theory, this is gameplay. I believe she said.
She can feel them.
It's theoretical gameplay. Slipping.
Theoretically, this is as good as we could make it look if we had the funding. It's like, stares at Microsoft.
It's like the old Assassin's Creed like pitch trailers that got released not too long ago, where it's purely animation, but the animation is so close to what actually happens in the game. It's kind of crazy.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah.
The new Assassin's Creed game is launching with a filter to desaturate the fuck out of it and make it look like the original for some reason. Just if you really want to go back to, yeah. There's always a
part of you that ugh. I mean, I'm not gonna sit here and say it didn't look clean on the 360, but we've got better tech now. And
a part yeah. that
dies. No, no. We need to hold ourselves back for the old tech's sake. I can
feel them. That's true. I didn't sign up for an ASMR session, please.
Yeah.
Isn't this, like, the original? Like, it was about, like, psychological, like, mental health issues and auditory issues.
I don't know about auditory, but I do remember it was, like, psychological grieving sort of stuff.
I remember something about audio being, like, a pretty big component, like, all the voices you're hearing and stuff like that.
I'm here. Well, maybe.
At least that was the impression I got.
I have no idea. You could be right, but I wouldn't know.
That's fair. You know what? I shouldn't speak either because I've never played it. And seen very little about it.
I remember watching someone streaming and it looked kind of
wonder if it's one of those.
Most people said it was good, so.
Maybe it's one of those games where it's better to like watch someone play it than to actually play it.
Maybe. What do you want me to do? I want you to break out of the crystal. Our soul fought through hell to find us. You were lost. Not anymore. Are you ready for what you will find here? What we will find? What if it's all for nothing? What is that? It's a dragon tear. Time to look at a memory. It's you. What will they do to us? What will we do to us? Okay, so this is definitely not gameplay. So far we've had Payday gameplay and that's it for gameplay.
I mean, some avowed gameplay.
Oh yeah, okay, yeah, no, you're right. Avowed did have gameplay.
I would like more gameplay though.
I would also like more gameplay.
If they have it structured so we open on like cinematic stuff, then midway through we start getting like gameplay previews, I'd be okay with that. But I do need gameplay at some point.
I would very much like to see gameplay.
I feel like if they're gonna do something like this where it's not gonna showcase gameplay, they need to call it like I will not let
them down. Cinematic reveal or something.
Yeah, like a cinematic like that. Preview thing.
Yeah. Who are these around you, Senua? Those you have saved, or those you also 2024. Wow, really?
Yeah, Microsoft, I mean, I guess a lot of the consoles right now have been having an issue of, like, actually having content come out.
I figured between Senua and Avowed, one of them will be coming in like late fall 2023, but no. Ooh. Oh, is this like Dragon 8?
Or like, yeah.
It's gotta be, because they've got Ichiban here.
Maybe DLC?
That game's pretty old for them to bring out DLC. Oh, hello.
I still need to play these games.
Well then. But so everybody was just like hanging out with this naked man on a beach, and now it just becomes a problem when he stands up?
You're right.
Oh, that'd be cool if they're going to like Okinawa or wherever this is. Instead of being in Tokyo.
The meme of covering up junk with placements and camera stuff will always not make me laugh. Or always make me laugh.
He's confused. I like how everyone's just cool with it. Is this A, Infinite Wealth? Oh, it's gotta be 8. They have a Mobius in there. Early 2024. Interesting.
So late 2020. I mean, yes, early 24. Gotta get it.
Yeah. There you go again, honey.
Oh, hey, it's Bethesda. Vault. Oh, eh.
I've heard this game got pretty good over the time they've supported it from where it launched.
Oh yeah, because they put a bunch of single player stuff into it.
Yeah.
They made it like
it should have shipped with.
Yeah.
But like I'm always tempted. They gave it out for free on PlayStation, so I have it, but
no matter if you roam alone or spend your time with friends, you'll find a home in Appalachia. So is this just an ad for 76? Before the war, along with loads of friendly folks to meet and enemies galore. Our world is always changing. Greater foes are overthrown as we embark on expeditions into thrilling new unknowns. Yes, from Appalachian settlements to Nuka World on tour. You're never short on things to do or places to explore. Think you've seen it all, eh? Well, how about this? Pack your bags for an escape of Epicurean bliss. Put your rad shield on.
I feel like Fallout 4 was the last time I was excited about a AAA release.
Yeah,
a while ago.
That's actually a really good point. Because I was pumped for Fallout 76.
Hey, I bought the collector's edition. With the helmet.
Our friend got the helmet too.
Answer the call of Vault 76. Play it now with Xbox Game Pass. Oh, it's just on Game Pass. Okay. Atlantic City? Oh, man. World premiere. I kind of just passed off. Oh, hey, we're doing like a DLC. Completely apropos of nothing else in that trailer. Is this Wukong? No, it's Capcom.
Oh, are we getting Silent Hill? Fuck yeah! Wait,
Capcom is not Silent Hill.
Yep.
That's Konami.
You're having a day, honey.
I really am.
Yeah.
Well, because they had the Silent Hill reveal last year, and one of the imagery they gave was very similar.
Yeah, it was F, and it was
like a feudal also, Japan.
Yeah, well, not feudal. I think it was like in the 60s or something. I like the color usage here.
Yeah.
I'm here for it. Even if it's not Silent Hill.
Oh,
that's cool. Maki would probably be all for this.
I
might be all for this too.
Like, I appreciate when a game is creepy and colorful.
Right?
Like, thank you for not just making my screen mostly black.
Yeah.
For your horror. Like, let me see colors and be disturbed.
Hmm. Yeah, get him. I actually really like this, how this looks. We got more gameplay.
Gameplay, yeah. It was literally gameplay.
Okay.
Oh, and you got bros. Oh, you bring in the Power Rangers.
Is this a isometric? Like a Diablo?
It doesn't look like it's quite as far back.
Yeah.
Path of the Goddess. That looks cool.
Yeah.
Also, the Reach for the Moon engine. Another first party Xbox.
General Motors' historic commitment to performance.
Oh, it's gotta be Forza.
Is embodied in two of its iconic brands, Chevrolet and Cadillac.
Are we gonna get the actual like Forza sequel, like the simulator Forza?
I think so. Because what was the one that we were ripping on last year? Was it Horizons?
Horizons. Yeah, Forza Horizons. I think it was.
Yeah. So I think it's 8. Has been a celebrated champion. I think it's Forza 8.
I really like simulator racing games. I've had fun with Project Cars. A lot.
I mean, they can be fun, but I'm not a huge car guy, so, you know.
With the innovators behind the new Forza
Motorsport. It's not... Here it is. Yep, there it was. Forza Motorsport.
Forza Motorsport and General Motors are pairing their strengths in technical excellence and sophisticated modern design to take bold steps into the future and bring that experience to gamers. I'm thrilled to welcome the Cadillac V-Series.R and the Corvette E-Ray to the home of competition.
Oh, you know who would be pumped about this? Alex.
I know you're ready. You've got this.
Oh yeah, bump that Corvette up on the wall.
I pull the NASCAR maneuver.
Yeah, pull that NASCAR.
That still was wild. And then they made it illegal, so it'll never happen again.
Well, I mean, you know, it's one of those rules that exists because somebody actually fucking did it, you know?
Like, that was probably the coolest thing NASCAR's done in a long time.
Yeah. I love that he's like, yeah, I used to be able to glitch the shit out of this old GameCube NASCAR game by just running into the wall. That was your best lap yet. And apparently it actually works in real life.
Are we going to get a Forza Motorsports movie to compete with the Gran Turismo movie?
God, I hope so. Oh, it's just Motorsport. And it's coming out in October.
Okay, a 2023 release. Hell yeah.
Hey,
are we going to get something for the summer, please?
No.
Do they have a summer game? Don't
I don't think they have a summer game.
You're right. I don't think anyone really has a summer game, which is great for game golf, but
Well, I mean, FF16 coming out in like a couple weeks.
Oh, Dragon Age? No.
No. Oh, it was Bethesda. This looks like it's Elder Scrolls Online, if I had to guess.
I am the one who knows. I tried so hard to like that game.
Oh, hey, it's Romance Mora. I remember playing like the playtest beta before the game actually came out. But I was in college and like didn't have time, so I only played like a couple hours on it.
I tried a couple of times to get into Elder Scrolls Online. Couldn't do it.
Yeah.
I broke Tony's heart because he was so pumped when I told him I'd play with him and give it a go, and I didn't even make it like half an hour.
Jeez. I wonder if they'll actually show something from the newer Elder Scrolls that's supposed to come out.
I wonder aren't if they're they saying that's dropping after, like, a long ways after Starfield?
Probably. I was always figuring probably 2025. Like, 2024, 2025. But I will say, it is... I saw an article, like, this week that said it's been 5 years since they announced Elder Scrolls 6.
And we have seen nothing. Why they announced it so soon.
I forget. Because I think... I want to say that, like, that same E3 is when they announced, like, a bunch of multiplayer stuff. So they were like, oh, we have to, like, make sure people are okay and, like, they understand that we're just putting out... We're working on those single-player games. Because, like, Starfield was announced at that same conference. Also, Overwatch.
Huh.
Wait, what is this that we're getting shown here? Because they don't have a story mode anymore.
It's what the story mode was gonna be.
Yeah, it's the cutscenes we've already made.
The event that they're doing to try and make up for getting rid of campaign.
Okay, I have a counter for what they could do. Everything they've done with the campaign, just turn it into a feature film animation.
I mean, yeah, that might just be what this is. I don't know. They have gameplay snippet, like actual gameplay in here every once in a while, but... Oh, it's Metal Gear Rex. That really was just Metal Gear Rex.
Oh, new game modes, okay.
But no story mode.
So it looks like they're doing
co-op stuff. Yeah, but they're not gonna... And then the story missions. So I feel like the what they have here is still the PvE stuff, but... They're not doing all the things they were going to do with the PvE. Which...
Well, yeah, that's what they...
Is a shame. Because it looked really cool.
Was that a new character that they showed right there? What do they do
these
now?
Hold on, let me go type in the
silhouette they showed before they did all the names.
Oh, I think there that was like a very... Kiriko.
Yeah.
Was it? Because she had a really big sword and a different silhouette, I thought. Or like a really big gun.
It looked like I think her... this is Tacticus. It looked like her alt skin.
What is Tactica.
Oh, whoa, what is this?
This also leaked, so. It's a tactics game with Persona 5 characters.
Oh, hell yeah.
I kind of like the chibi.
Yeah, it's pretty cute.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, it's pretty neat.
You know what? I do wish Persona had more strategy. So maybe this is what I want.
Maybe.
It has like the Pokemon strategy right now of just like pick your strongest attack every time and just do that.
I mean, yeah. Well, if I remember correctly, you were able to actually like string turns together based on whether you can.
That is single-handedly what like pulled me into that game and kept me interested. That is a really nice feature.
Yeah.
I also wish more games took a play out of their book and had like fully rendered like 2D illustrated like animations like that are just like a TV show for cutscenes sometimes, like for special moments, because that's so cool.
Yeah. Play it day one on Game Pass. Oh hey, another Bethesda. Starfield,
you guys
what?
Think they're talking about Game Pass enough?
Also, who made the St. Louis Freedom March in Starfield? In
the
unknown.
The wonder is, are they actually going to just do this in the middle? I think they said they're going to do like a trailer and then we're going to get an extended session in the end.
Oh, okay. I can't wait to play this game 2 years after it comes out when it's actually like playable.
Oh, right.
Yeah, I'll wait for when they realize they probably should have just made it multiplayer.
We're all here yeah. Because we're committed to the biggest yeah, this should have been the multiplayer game they made.
What's out there?
You know what the worst thing for this game was, though? Was, No Man's Sky fixed itself.
Yeah. The fact that they trimmed down a lot on certain things, like, I don't think it's like, you can't fly onto planets, you go into loading screens, the planets, when you fly to them, and I don't think there's as much as people are gonna think there's gonna be in terms of, like, the sim gameplay.
Man, I forgot, I was gonna write down all the games that were announced. Or like halfway through, and it's too late now.
These artifacts could be everything we've been looking for. Another great secret the universe is asking us to unravel.
I am a sucker, though, for space mystery. God, am I a sucker for space mystery.
Oh, okay, that animation didn't look like it was from Skyrim.
Okay, that actually looked pretty good.
We are not stopping. Whatever lies at the end of this road will change humanity.
Maybe I will. Forever. Maybe I will be happy with that.
Maybe.
I'll probably end up playing it at some point. It's like one of those games where it's just like, I'm not hyped for this to come out, but I will play it out of curiosity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's too big not to, like, want to experience at least once.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Kind of, honestly, that's kind of how I feel about Tears of the Kingdom. Wait, September 6th? Wasn't it September, like, later?
Oh.
That's close to summer.
Close. Stay tuned for Starfield Direct afterwards.
I do like the aesthetic of, like, almost analog space.
Yeah, analog space is really cool. Alien fucking nailed that aesthetic.
Yeah. Isolation was such a good game.
Anxiety inducer simulator part though.
Is that ad part of...
Do you have waffles strapped to his back?
I just got an ad that popped up and I couldn't tell if it was part of the conference or not.
No, this isn't Summer Games Fest, which did have multiple ads pop up in the middle.
Is this Death Stranding, but up?
Death's up.
Why has he got a coconut with a mud sack in it?
Oh, you know, just in case he needs it.
Come here. Yeah. Yeah,
I like how he's got, like, a little grub. Don't nod. Wow, really? A don't nod game with gameplay again? Jesus, that's two for two.
I know I was joking when I said Death Stranded, but up, but...
I mean, that's looking like it's not so wrong.
A climbing game would be pretty cool, though. Like, that feels like it hasn't been explored enough. Like, the closest we got was Assassin's Creed climbing mechanics back in, like, 2013.
Yeah, but those are, those aren't that great.
Yeah, it's
old button
to
scale wall
stuff.
Is, you know.
But like, it's also just like, I'm always kind of down for an adventure platformer.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that looks interesting.
And they have the Disney marketed cute side character.
Yep. It's a little grub, just for you. Sea of Thieves, Sea of Thieves. Oh wait, no, not Sea of Thieves. No, not Sea of Thieves. Dang it, I forgot the. I forgot what was the stupid name of that game that
we
played.
That one doesn't exist.
That's what I was hoping for.
Skull and fucking dumb.
This might be an Amnesia, because I saw the Chinese room in there.
Oh, they just came out with a new Amnesia.
That's right, they did, didn't they?
I haven't picked it up yet, but I love their games. This does have a similar vibe that I might be here for.
Yeah.
A good horror game? In the ocean? Oh.
Still Wakes the Deep.
Oh, okay. Okay, you have my attention.
Yeah, that looks interesting.
God damn it, you lost my attention.
Early 24. A lot of these are early 2024. To be fair.
Yeah, I've been seeing a lot of 24s.
I almost wish they would, like, order their shit really reveals it, like, chronologically, so, like...
I want it chronologically backwards, where they show the furthest first, and then, like, build the hype to, like...
That's exactly what's about what to I was be released.
That person runs around like they got a load in their pants.
They do. But wouldn't that be so cool? Because the most memorable moments are the ones that you saw last, and they're the stuff coming out soonest.
Yeah. Yeah, but then you couldn't, like, end the conference on something that actually surprises people. Because it's so far off in the distance.
Exactly. Don't end load your bullshit trailers 10 years before the game comes out just for an applause.
Bethesda.
Yeah. It's not for me, but this game looks cute.
Dungeons of Hinterberg.
That art style isn't doing it for me.
Yeah, there is something just, like, off about it. I don't know what.
Like, the character... Like, the thick outlines on the character.
Oh, shit! Keanu Reeves is back!
Oh my god!
Is Johnny Silverhand in the upcoming expansion for...
Oh, the DLC!
So this, I think, actually got leaked, too, because this was... Cyberpunk Phantom Liberty here was at Summer Games Fest. Like, playable on the floor, if I remember correctly.
Okay.
So I figured it would show up at some point.
I'll give it to Cyberpunk. I actually played through it start to finish end of last year, and I had a great time with it. I didn't run into really any bugs.
That's pretty much what I figured. I'm just kind of waiting for the price to go down a little more, and unfortunately with the expansion coming out, it probably won't, but...
I think I ended up getting it, like, half off when it was during, like, some summer sale after the game had a horrible launch.
I'm waiting for that, like, 15 to 20 mark, but...
Yeah.
That's just me. That's what I do with a lot of games that are, like, big that I'm not necessarily into, as I wait for them to get hit, like... 15-20 bucks and then pick them up.
You know,
and so it is my honor and pleasure to give you and introduce the official trailer for Phantom Liberty.
Also, I wasn't paying attention. Did he say breathtaking yet?
He might have. You could get the CD key for $20 right now.
Ooh.
There's gotta be
or $22 on the Epic Store. It's on sale. It's yeah. Mm. There you go.
I'm dying. There's nothing can stop that.
And we'll want to take bets on how buggy the DLC is.
Yeah, no, it'll work. It'll be fine. Because they've fixed a lot of the engine problems that they were actually having. So I think the DLC will be fine. And of course, when that Cyberpunk anime came out, this game had a resurgence, so...
That's when I picked it up, actually.
Yeah.
That's right. I forgot about that.
You want to be free.
Don't they have Idris Elba?
Idris Elba?
Yeah, I believe they do have Idris Elba.
I think that was him. That's
I
cool.
Want to say in like the like original announced trailer they show Idris Elba.
Get Myers out of there. Yeah. Time to evac. Her safety
is the top priority. This looks to be a more linear experience, which I am definitely down for.
Well, this is an expansion, so it'll be a part of the, you know, part of the base game.
Oh, it's not going to be like a standalone expansion where you just kind of load into the side story.
I don't think so.
That's fair. Oh, there he is.
Yep, it's absolutely him. Goes, people get hurt, bodies drop. Just want what Songbird promised me. The cure. Situation's changed.
need to know if you're with me.
Illusion of freedom draws in the desperate. Pick your truth, V.
Come on, got iron in your head. Gotta put it to someone's head. Pull the trigger.
If I don't do anything and do it soon, I'll die.
September 26th. There you go.
September, I guess, usually is the big month.
Unless you're looking at something that really is big, then a lot of times they'll push it to, like, November.
Oh, yeah. September, November, December area. Yeah. I wish we had more moments like that in the beginning of the year.
City Skylines 2. I don't actually know.
Oh, at some point I do have to check out the Dead Space remake.
I think this is City Skylines 2. I might have actually gotten it correct. I like how they picked up the lighting engine for it, though. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, good lighting engine will take a game a long ways.
Yeah, that's very true. You make it happen.
These games always look so interesting, but they're so not for me, and I wish they were. Like, I wish I enjoyed this, because I'm always impressed with what they do with them.
You make cities. Oh, October 24th. There you go.
Okay, so the earliest we've seen is a September release, right?
Yeah, I think it's Starfield with that September 6th.
Let's see if we can beat September.
No. Yawning. Oh shit, more Atlas? Oh my god! Oh my god, it's this project that's been dead forever! Oh my god, it's Project Re-Fucking Fantasy. I thought this was dead! They announced this thing like 10 years ago.
God damn.
Man, my favorite fucking Twitter character is gonna be so happy. Yeah, there's just this dude who, like, for, I don't know, probably years, ever since there's been rumors about the, Persona 3 remake, would go into every thread on Reddit and Twitter and everywhere and just say, doesn't exist. Which, of course, clearly now is bullshit. Wow, they are actually just taking UI elements from Persona 5.
Yeah.
You saw that too, didn't you?
I thought it was like a Persona universe game until I realized it wasn't.
It could be. I don't think it is. I think it's that Project Re-Fantasy thing. Metaphor Re-Fantasio. What the fuck?
Yeah, but it's published by Atlas, who publishes the Persona games.
It's also from the guy who created Personas 3, 4, and 5. Because that's his new studio there. Studio Zero or whatever. It's an internal studio within Atlas.
Humanity's cities have fallen.
Cool.
Our people's only means of survival is to seek sanctuary here. in the Belfry.
A really small tower for all of humanity. This world.
To find the origins of this evil. Crystal Chronicles?
Is it?
No. And to bring hope.
Oh, that is cool. That is actually a full city on the lighthouse. I just noticed all the buildings on the side of it.
Oh, yeah.
Co-op adventure.
I like the sound of that.
Oh, hey, it looks like Adventure Quest.
Oh, side scroller.
Okay. Oh, yeah, no, actually, it looks kind of like Tails combat.
I was thinking Trine.
Yeah, Trine would work.
It's by the same people who made Banner Saga, so it's probably very similar to their system.
Yeah.
Because our Banner Saga was kind of a side scroller.
Together, you can save humanity.
Towerborn. Not to be confused with Bloodborne. That's never coming out. You're never getting a re-release of Bloodborne or a sequel. It will forever exist on PS4.
Did they? I think they ported it to PC, right?
No.
Did they not?
Nope. Yeah. Not even close. That's probably never happening either.
It's been like the one thing everyone's been waiting for that hasn't happened.
That's wild. Yeah. And unfortunate.
In exile.
This city is a miracle.
Oh, that's right. They have PlayStation Now, so you could play it on PC.
Is this BioShock?
It had that vibe.
Very BioShock.
I loved BioShock Infinite.
It was all right. I wasn't
I think
super hyped on
it. Was I don't know why, but I really liked it. Like Sky City.
I mean, this looks pretty on the nose, right back in that aesthetic. If it is BioShock, but I don't think it is.
Is it the same devs? Because it looks like you're saying like.
So BioShock was like 2K, I think, published, and I forget who the actual dev was, but I don't think it was In Exile.
What's this?
Although, yeah, it's really got BioShock looking stuff in it. Although they already did time weirdness in Infinite, so.
Yeah, this is kind of weird how much they have taken from Infinite.
Yeah. Clockwork. Clockwork Revolution. Okay.
The top comment. I hope they have better writing team than BioShock Infinite. Yeah. This just feels like a spiritual redo.
That really does.
Thank you all for joining us. Today is a special day for me and the team. I'm excited to
For whatever reason, my first instinct was to say, oh, hey, it's Phil Spencer. Then I was like, that's not Phil Spencer. But apparently it was Phil Spencer, so I don't know.
The franchise in the modern era while staying true to its British style and humor. Compulsion and In Exile shared their first original experiences since joining Xbox with South of Midnight and Clockwork Revolution. And we are thrilled at how Avowed is shaping up for release next year from the RPG masters at Obsidian. In addition to Avowed, our studios will deliver Hellblade 2, an all-new Microsoft Flight Simulator.
Wait, all new?
And more in 2024.
All new Flight Sim.
Later this month,
okay.
Players can look forward to Elder Scrolls Online Necrom and Sea of Thieves Monkey Island. As we look to holiday, we will launch Starfield and Forza Motorsport, both built for Xbox Series X, S, and PC.
Well, that's a problem.
We're also honored to share
built it for the S
games today from our creative partners. like Star Wars Outlaws from Ubisoft Massive in collaboration with Lucasfilm Games. 33 Immortals from Thunder Lotus, Kunitsugami, Path of the Goddess from Capcom, and more Persona games coming to Game Pass thanks to our continued partnership with Sega Atlas. I'd also like to congratulate the Studio Zero team on Metaphor ReFantazio. It's great to be able to premiere what is next from the creators of Persona here in our showcase. We are focused on putting our players...
Yep, that's Project ReFantazy that they announced like 10 years ago and finally showed up.
No matter if you choose to play on Xbox...
It's finally here.
PC, we're over the cloud.
My favorite fucking Twitter character is going to be all happy.
When it comes to our consoles, we have heard your feedback on two fronts. First, we have significantly increased our supply of Xbox Series X, making it easier for fans to find globally. Second,
oh boy,
we know you've wanted more storage with Xbox Series S.
Ooh.
And I'm excited to share, we have some news there as well.
Is this just a separate hard drive that they're selling?
Have we circled back to memory cards?
Yes. What is this? Series S. Now with 1 terabyte. Oh, there you go. For an S? 350?
I couldn't imagine operating the console with under a terabyte nowadays. I mean, hell, like Call of Duty's like 150 on its own.
One more thing you've all been waiting
for. Not even 10 games.
Prepare for the most comprehensive deep dive we've
ever
done for the biggest game we've ever built.
I was hoping that they would have like a one more thing before the Starfield Direct. But,
the biggest game they've ever built.
There you go.
So
the biggest game that they had nothing
to
do with for the most part.
Yeah, the biggest game Xbox has ever done right here. Okay, I'll be right back.
All right, have fun. Watch this entire thing have no gameplay.
Hey everyone, thank you so much.
It's God Coward, there he is.
To Bethesda Game Studios. You know, we've been so lucky over the decades to make the kind of games that we love here, and that's thanks to all of you. From the Elder Scrolls to Fallout, we love creating these worlds and playing in them just as much as you do. And throughout all that time, we'd often talk about and dream of.
Oh, they had the extras just walking through in the back there.
We could take that feeling of being who you want to be and exploring a new world, but set it in space, where you weren't really limited in where you could go or what you could do. And that is Starfield. Obviously, we've come a long way since then. With the games we've built, our technology, and all of us here in the studio, we've done so much together, but, well, we've never tried to make a game
if
like this.
If this is just them, I'm going to be chatting about Starfield for a bit.
Many on the team.
No, I think it's like an actual, like, going to be a gameplay deep dive,
so
too.
Let's jump in and take a look.
So that's typically what Bethesda does when they're imminently going to release a game.
Well, I might pop out for this, then.
Starfield.
Oh yeah?
I don't give two shits about Starfield.
No, I kind of do. It's interesting.
I'm going to watch from my phone.
Luke cares, doesn't he? Luke will stick around.
Yeah. Luke's watching from his phone, I think.
Yeah, I'll hang out for a hot minute.
I'm going to pop out. See ya. Alrighty.
Have a good one.
Because the choice of where to go, it's not ours. I want to see what this game plays about.
And it wasn't until now that we had the technology to create it. From the rocks at your feet, to the mountains in the distance, to the people and creatures that live in these worlds.
Weird mushroom dinosaur.
That isn't just a backdrop.
That moon is. I am happy to see vegetated planets too, because up until now we'd only seen like barren, like moon-like aesthetic planet. Galaxy around you. So that makes me happy.
Our next generation lighting model uses
real-time global illumination to light the world based on the type of star
and the makeup. Man, it's the Gateway Arch here. The aliens stole the Gateway Arch.
We also have an all-new animation system. And of course, you can play it in third person.
It does look fantastic.
And you can play it in first person.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, this actually looks like there was some innovation done.
I take back some of the shit I've been shitting.
But you do explore differently in this game, given its scale. That usually involves exploring an area you've landed in. You can collect resources, do a mission, and maybe even stumble upon something unexpected.
The abandoned mine. Spacer punk.
You know, the gunplay actually looks pretty good, which is saying a lot for Bethesda.
I mean, it actually looks like things are dying in a realistic way as opposed to being bullet sponges. Oh, fuck.
God. Dog bark is probably going to mute.
Nah, it's fine.
We do love the time where the mute button is. Oh, God. You to pick everything
up, and you can view all that in your data menu. This is the hub for everything you're doing, from your skills to your ship, your missions, and your inventory. We love to pack a ton of detail in every object, from all of your weapons to spacesuits to food. We just obsess over the details and food. We obsess over food. When you're done exploring, you can walk back or fast travel to your ship. We have companions and crew you can take with you. I left Vasco here back at my ship.
Welcome back, Captain Howard.
And he can even say your name. Let's head out.
Oh, they just ported that in from Fallout 4. Hey, they can say 1,000 different names.
The wonder and majesty of space exploration. To evoke the romance of the golden age of early spaceflight. And we've been referring to this approach as NASA Punk. This means a design language where the tech is advanced, yet still looks grounded and relatable.
For us, it's that contrast, that's where the visual interest is.
Relatable interstellar NASA, travel, yes.
Which is the rigid, hard, function over style, and then Punk, which is all about style.
You can see that visual style.
We'd love to see. In your ship. Like being able to run around on your ship during combat. It's such a niche thing that I enjoy, but like being able to like do repairs and stuff as like the hull is being shot at would be so cool.
Yeah, but like there's no way you could actually do that as one person in a ship.
That's what hurts me, unless there's like some autopilot or maybe like some like micro mini games you can play during travel.
Yeah.
You can see all of its info and resources. You can choose a
like I want. I think if anything, I just want a reason to be able to interact around my ship.
You can view all yeah. the planets in the system. Obviously, the game is big, and it's here you can see planets that.
Like how they have the gravity distortion around the sun. Life on them,
versus the yeah.
See the little gravity well map.
Resource heavy. Zoom out even further to see all the systems in this part of the galaxy. Here, you can plot a course to ones that are light years away. This uses your ship's grav drive to fold space and jump to these systems. And you will need to upgrade your ship and skills if you want to
fold
jump to
space.
The most distant ones. But for now, we'll plot
so
a course to
fold a paper in half and punch a pencil through it.
We can find the city
yeah.
of New Atlantis.
New Atlantis, by the way.
I'm here for it.
Welcome to UC Space. Maintain your current course while we scan your ship's cargo.
Someone's been playing Lost in Space. Netflix. I think that was the name of the planet they used in the new season.
I have no idea.
Guess it's fairly generic.
Oh, I bet it is.
City like New Atlantis, your eyes are guided upwards to just these boundless, vast buildings.
It's the biggest city we've ever made, not just in size, but also in the amount of custom art, crowds, and quests.
So the main focus when we're designing a city is obviously what supports the story. We try and tell as many small stories as possible.
This is a colony war memorial.
Why has he got ice blocks? Oh, they're shields. Never mind.
Make the space feel like it's full of real
characters. I thought the robot had like big ice block pauldrons for some reason. Think
about it. Buddy, it's coffee.
It's also where your adventure with Constellation begins.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about.
By the time is that Burnwood from the Hitman series? Mythical group.
Most people don't even know they exist anymore. They're the last true explorers in the galaxy, and they're trying to find the answers to some of humanity's biggest questions.
The artifacts are so different, so alien, and I'm certain one of them reached out and spoke to you. The artifact, if you could place it on the table here.
Oh my god, look at how it's coming together.
That means there's a set
built by an intelligence outside the settled systems.
It's definitely an eclectic cast of characters. You've got Sarah Morgan, the ex-soldier and adventurer, now Constellation's leader. Mateo, the theologian who believes that there's definitely something else out there. Noelle, the gifted scientist and Sarah Morgan's protege, and Walter, a very successful businessman in the settled systems and Constellation's financier.
Anything goes as long as you have the money.
There's also Vlad, the ex-pirate.
Vlad?
Sarah, the former space cowboy, and Barry.
You know what I hate about these pirates? Completely resistant to my otherwise irresistible charm.
Man, there's that Bethesda dead stare. His irresistible charm. There it is, baby.
I knew it was going to make an appearance.
But had to. Oh, goodness me. What was that thing?
Oh, yeah. Give me some space war.
Where you'll find New Atlantis, the first major human settlement in space. The people who live here value law, discipline, and the legacy of humanity. They consider themselves the true children of Earth.
You ever think of joining up with the Vanguard? Help the United Colonies, even get your UC citizenship?
New Atlantis isn't the only city within the United Colonies. The city of Cydonia on Mars to this day serves as the largest mining facility for the United Colonies.
All right, we got Martian Town. Can we visit Earth?
United Colonies reach, you might find yourself in a much more wild and independent coalition of star systems. This is Freestar Collective Space. The capital of the Freestar Collective is Aquila City.
The Stone Root Inn is an Aquila City fixture.
Their engine looks awesome for this.
Yeah. Relies on judgment and intuition. Actually, it does look pretty good.
Like, seeing that western town, immediately being able to compare it to, like, New Vegas and seeing how much better it looks now.
As a pleasure city, where almost anything goes.
Oh, Space Vegas.
Morality issues? This definitely isn't the job for you.
Wow, oh my god, it was so bad there. The Bethesda stare.
Yeah, as long as we get, like, pre-rendered cinematics for important moments, I can be okay with it. Like, kind of the Mass Effect mingle of dead stare, but then cutscenes.
Yeah.
But they've never really been big on cutscenes in their games.
Not really. Granted, this is a new, you know, IP, so they could change some stuff up.
Like, if we could break in-engine cutscenes and just have, like, some actually well-done cutscenes. Brave runner here to challenge the Red Mile. Cinematics, I should say.
They think the galaxy is theirs. They are wrong. It belongs to the Crimson Fleet. It always has.
In Starfield, we're pushing our cities and settlements further than we ever have before. It's all there. Waiting for you.
When do I get to make my own settlement, though? Future. Can I make a moon colony?
Ready to get out there?
Throughout the galaxy, there are so many things to see and stories to experience. But the most important story is the one that you tell.
How come they haven't shown, like, combat yet, really? Character creation.
And yeah.
I think people are going to be really excited when they see all of the improvements we've made.
One of the biggest overhauls was done through our character generation system. We scanned a wide range of faces from different age groups and ethnicities. And by mixing and matching all that data, we were able to create highly detailed and diverse characters.
We used that exact system to create all the characters and NPCs you're going to see in the game. So any character you see almost always is a character you could make yourself.
Oh man, what kind of horrible monster mash people can we make in that character creator?
Come on. Okay. Take it easy.
I doubt it's going to be anything like Street Fighter 6's, but...
no physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out. You know who you are?
Okay, this cutscene's good enough for me in terms of, like, they seem a little alive in their expressions.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
You start your character creation journey as though you're cycling through employee records.
I think
you'll pick from a lineup of 40 presets, and that'll be your...
Goodbye, Gavin.
Later.
See ya.
Your journey from there can
be Luke got big.
Or as quick as you want it to be.
Oh,
this new
big on the screen.
More to offer than ever before.
Shrink you down. You don't get to be that big anymore.
It's also the simplest character generation system we ever had.
Knocking me down a few notches.
No, I don't want a simple character creator, damn it. I want to make horrible Cronenberg monsters.
Dermesthetic and makeup, blemishes, scars, piercings, teeth settings. It's a lot, but I think it's the most fun to use.
Okay,
character creation is more than just how you look. This is also where you start to decide who you want to be. That's where backgrounds come in. Backgrounds give you a bit of backstory and start you out with three basic skills.
From chef to dusty. You know, the crew still has a betting pool about which restaurant critic you must have crossed to wind up here.
What's great about backgrounds is you never know when yours is going to come in handy. You could be in the middle of a fancy restaurant, talking to some guy, and suddenly you learn he needs a beast hunter to help track down a monster.
Fine. I probably should stick to professionals anyway, given what happened the last time.
We're also
I don't know, that looked pretty Bethesda.
Even further, up to three traits. Traits are completely optional, and they come with their own advantages and disadvantages. You could choose to meet your biggest fan.
Oh wow, they just brought that dude back? They brought the adoring fan back from Oblivion? I'm pretty sure it's the exact same... I'm pretty sure it's the exact same voice actor, too.
You have to pay some credits to support your parents, but they're very sweet, and it's really fun to go visit them.
Honey, we got you can visit your parents!
I came across some hostile thoughts in space. But because I had chosen a tree,
I wonder if you get shamed if you don't visit enough. I was able to get
by without any Probably.
There's another great one.
Just like Animal Crossing all over again.
Your health is low,
yeah.
But mercenaries will randomly show up and try to kill you. No matter what you choose, there will be plenty of ways for you to tell your story. And if you want to remove a trait, there are ways to do that too.
What a view! It's a feast for the eyes. Off we go. To another adventure!
We'll let you discover that on your own.
What do you mean? It's a Bethesda game. You can't kill important NPCs like that.
Once you've built the perfect character, that's when your journey can really begin. We took what we loved about skills and perks from our previous games, and put them together to create an all-new skill system.
Each time you level up...
Oh my god, it's a giant land octopus.
Used to unlock or rank up
skills. Jesus.
That's horrifying.
Ranks are unlocked by like how we still got the ragdoll death. With that
skill. Oh yeah, of course. Ragdoll is the most fun...
It really is.
...become increasingly difficult as you work your way to higher ranks. With our five different skill trees and four...
Oh yeah, what's hacking look like in this?
There's a lot to choose from.
I don't know, I hope they show it.
I like the Xenosociology skill.
I love some of the mini-games in the Fallout.
Boost pack, out of the gate. I'm boost packing everywhere.
I like maxing out my physical tree so I can get neuro strikes and just punch my way through combat.
Neuro strikes? You mean just punching a dude in the head? Oh, okay. That goodbye, bud. Fun.
Invest in the skills that suit your playstyle.
I'm very much a stealth player. So.
Oh, did that guy actually react to where he was shot?
A favorite part about being stealthy.
Maybe.
Looks like he shot his leg out. If that's so, that's pretty cool.
And then jumping out and springing on people?
Whenever possible, I like to talk my way through situations.
Is the area off limits? Fine, I'll issue you an access card.
I'm more of a run and gun player. I like doing the death from above thing where I boost pack over guys and I throw landmines at them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
I always want to do the other methods, but running around just shooting the fuck up everyone is so satisfying.
Yeah, I mean, I think for a lot of my Skyrim, I was just like run around in stealth, but. I don't know. It always seems like the path of least resistance to just do a stealth playthrough.
Exploration. Yeah, I think stealth... I go back. All our games. I trap myself in a corner, whereas I don't necessarily want to do stealth, but sometimes I'll just only do it because it's the easier, and it's like feels like the way they want you to do it. Like the higher challenge.
Yeah.
I want that like crisp success, but then when it goes shit, I just kill everyone. To help us make the world feel believable.
From the way we approached planetary atmospheres to the way we placed biomes based on the planet's distance from the sun.
Cool.
We had created a grounded world.
Storms actually would be really cool, how they handle like different weather.
When you leave a planet and head into space, you'll be navigating asteroid fields, having chance meetings with interesting strangers, dogfighting in space.
There's interesting people shooting at you.
Yeah, I do want to see more of the space combat.
It's all out there.
I'm kind of surprised at how decent it looks.
Right? I was really expecting to go into this and shit on it.
Because whether it's on the surface of a planet, the alleys of a city, or the vastness of space, you never know what you'll find.
Also, ship. Can I make a Gundam ship?
Your ship is almost like.
That's what I want to know.
Character or home, you can make all your own. I think you'll be blown away by the amount of stuff you can do. You can buy a ship.
I'm sure you can find something you like.
Customize and upgrade that ship. And hire a crew to keep it up and running.
Ooh, interesting.
Okay. Okay, I get a crew.
Every yeah, you get a crew.
Technician where you can purchase, sell, and modify ships.
Anything I can help you with?
Maybe you start off with a speedy fighter that's perfect for bounty hunting. Then you might round out your ship roster with a hulking space freighter to run cargo missions, or even do a little smuggling. For now, though, we're going to take our starting ship, the Frontier, and make some changes. You can customize and upgrade everything you see here. And you have two ways to do that. You can quickly upgrade individual systems like your weapons or shields, or you can deep dive and enter the ship builder mode. Here you can change anything.
I wonder if we'll get the monotony and physicality of like having to load stuff into your ship, because I unapologetically love that. Like if I have to start loading up freights into ship for like cargo deliveries.
An improved grav drive allows
okay, this is pretty cool.
Space jumps.
Yeah, this actually looks like a pretty nice little shipbuilding mod.
Your paint job to get the exact look you want. The parts you choose to build with don't just affect your ship's stats. They'll also affect what you can do inside your ship.
This game looks pretty big, so I hope it doesn't feel empty.
Or for storing and displaying.
Yeah.
Starfield's in-game ship manufacturers bring their own look and feel to every piece of your ship. From living quarters, to cargo holds, mess halls,
and control. It'd be really cool if there was an enemy that could board your ship, so you actually get an excuse to like play in your environment a little more that you built out.
Yeah.
Frontier is a practical ship. Like a horror area, like something on your ship you gotta investigate it, or like RNG things that can happen to your ship, like we have something wrong, you need to find it and repair it.
I make them look like animals? The HMS Platypus, as I called it.
Where it had Her Majesty's ship Platypus? Oh no, it's His Majesty's now. Spiders, never mind.
So it's really
Optimus Prime?
Your imagination is.
Oh yeah.
Your home among the stars the way you want. Oh, well, there goes my answer. You can roughly make a Gundam. We'll call your ship home. Roughly.
Ready to lift off when you are, Captain.
Engines ready.
The Frontier is fueled and ready, Captain.
Some of the members of can you get multiple ships, or if you want to, like, do you have to realign your entire ship if you want to do something different? Until we either find an artifact, or this lead
runs dry. Each companion comes with their own valuable skills for your ships and outposts, as well as unique quest lines. Eventually, some friendships might blossom into romance.
I would have ever really loved anyone except you.
And if you're looking
for
extra help on your ship, you can always hire additional crew at spaceports.
Are we going to get a marriage speedrun out of this game, too?
You'll also meet potential crew members out in the world.
Still think there might be a spot for me on your ship? I gotta get off this rock.
Assign crew to your ship or outposts, and their unique skills will affect how they run. And just like companions, most crew members can lend a hand in the field.
FTL.
Take Bosco, for instance.
So just any random person from your ship can go out with you? Okay.
Please avoid getting shot. You might die.
I still want to give it almost a humanoid personality.
I wonder how they handle death.
They don't.
They just get knocked down until you finish combat kind of thing.
Probably. That would be my guess.
I would almost like that, because when I did like Skyrim and stuff like that, always having to babysit them because I might permalose a character sucked.
Yeah.
I never used him because of that. Let's take to the
sky. Wait, well, that was also just like the little guards, right? Or were there other companions? I could have swore there were some companions that couldn't die.
There might have been, but like even some of the named ones, like Lydia and stuff that you could marry, like could permadie. And that problem with like New Vegas too. It's always so afraid of using any of my companions.
Yeah. Well, and that is really cool for us. I thought that was only if you played at like a certain difficulty that they died in New Vegas.
I think I played on hardcore.
Ah, okay. Well, yeah, there
you go. So I kind of did it to myself.
Yeah, I was going to say, that one you put on yourself.
We've extended that sense of control to ship combat. It's not about just hitting your triggers to
fire
your weapons. It's a complex dance between your piloting skills and our power allocation system. Boosting power to your engines will make your ship faster.
Okay. So Elite Danger is in here a little bit. The amount of time it takes before you can make a jump.
Brav, jump, go!
And moving your power to your weapons and shields means you're ready for a fight. You should always be on your toes because you're not alone out there.
So they just took that Star Trek concept of like all engine or all power to the shields or whatever. That's literally just what that is.
Very similar to like how Elite Dangerous and No Man's Sky handle it, which I guess makes sense. Oh, you can okay.
After destroying an enemy ship, you can loot the remains from your cockpit. You can always turn the ship that engages you into scrap. But you can also take a more personal approach by docking with the enemy vessel and boarding their ship.
There you go.
Yes. Okay.
Ship to ship combat. Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
That's pretty sick.
Once you've taken control of an enemy ship,
it's yours. Damn it. This game actually looks kind of good. And retrieve it at spaceport.
But space is way more than fighting for your life. Okay, so you can have a fleet. They got like 9 ships in their fleet right now. Planet side, there are plenty of sights to see and stops just to make. Tops at like 4 of 9. Adventure.
Ah.
Like these massive star yards. Walk the halls, talk to the crew. Maybe get talked into buying a whole new ship.
A civilian. Okay, so you can get ships.
Let's see about getting you a proper ship, one worthy of you.
Maybe you'll dock with a gigantic battleship like the UC Vigilance. Or rub elbows with the galaxy's wealthy elite on a cruise ship fit for the stars. There are plenty of personal encounters to be had as well. You can hail any ship you come across to trade, swap info, or maybe even commit an act of piracy.
Let's do this.
When I'm playing, I generally go crazy. I definitely go like the more piracy routes. I want to take over ships. I'm going to board ships. I'm like, this is now mine. I steal all the sandwiches and put them, you know, in my cargo hold that I have specifically for sandwiches. I don't want to play the hero, but I want to go out.
There you go. Nice little salami sandwich for you.
From people as quickly as possible.
Wonderfully modeled salami sandwich.
They're so well modeled. I wonder if these are all scans.
They probably are. Oh, it's Grandma! The best moments are the ones you discover. You can go visit Grandma, too!
The thing I love most about Starfield is that it is a Bethesda game through and through. It's really about going to strange new places, meeting interesting people, and getting sidetracked on zany adventures. Then, realizing 2 hours later...
Including meeting the Pharaoh?
...completely new story.
You're... human. We thought we were the only ones to leave Earth.
That DNA is so present here. It's in our random encounters, it's in our handcrafted quests. And it feels so cool to play it and just make your own path in this universe. There are over 1,000 planets out there, just waiting for you to visit. We want you to feel like explorers. Breaking ground on new planets, exploring every inch of a mostly untouched galaxy.
So that looked like when you land on a planet, it's a cutscene. You don't get to just, like, land.
I have heard that the transversal is a lot of cutscenes in load-in.
Yeah, I've heard that too, but... I mean, we're watching this right now, so I'll let them show any of that.
Yeah, I'm pleasantly surprised so far. This is actually probably my favorite reveal we've had today.
I mean, yeah. Hey
everybody,
it looks surprisingly
so
good.
Stuff,
thank you, God Coward.
Take a little break and show you something a little bit.
Oh,
different.
It's the controller that leaked.
So much detail into our game.
They're probably going to show the controller that leaked.
To bring that oh, good point.
The world with our collector's editions, and for this game, we've done a watch. It is the Constellation Explorer's watch. This is the watch that you actually get in the game that acts as part of your HUD, where it's the compass and then environmental information. It connects to your phone to give you notifications and other information. And we've also designed this really cool case that it comes with, Eastvon.
Yeah, we really took as much care in designing.
I wish I liked watches.
Watch. Our attention to detail. And
yeah, I
totally translates to.
I'm not a big watch guy.
Inspired by the cases that the astronauts used during the Apollo era to bring back samples from the moon.
Wait, is he not wearing the watch in a presentation hyping their watch? He's wearing a different company's watch.
That one dude is indeed wearing a different company's watch. I don't know about God Coward.
I think really he's actually wearing it. I'll give him credit.
Okay. You'll find it very useful out there.
Tells the time. We actually have something else.
It's dangerous to go alone.
Tell
hardware team, and together we have created.
Oh yeah, he's got it.
Limited edition Starfield controller.
Oh yeah, awesome. Here you go.
Now, you know, our favorite controller.
Like I said, that controller leaked a while ago. Controls of your
spaceship. I remember seeing some photos of that.
Yeah.
We've created the first ever custom headset with Xbox.
Oh boy.
A perfect pairing with that controller.
I mean, it's a pretty neat looking Xbox controller.
Yeah. hope you never want to change your controls and remap them.
Yeah. Left! Just in case you didn't know.
The whole side of the headset being the volume knob is actually pretty cool.
That is actually kind of cool.
Yeah, that headset looks pretty nice.
Yeah.
In every one of our games, we always put so much care into all those little details that breathe life into our worlds. But Starfield isn't just a Bethesda
game. God damn it, Bethesda, after 20 years, you're pulling me back in with a new IP.
I mean, they had to at some point, right?
Yeah.
Galactic level. The freedom to experience both the exciting planets and the quiet ones. Scanning a planet before you land is a great way to get a sneak peek at the available resources you can use for crafting, building, and customizing.
Chlorine gas!
This whole system
to yeah, it's Mass Effect.
Have the scanner minigame.
Send out the probes.
I honestly played the shit out of those minigames. It was so therapeutic for me.
I mean, I did it for the resources, but...
We stitched together block of terrain.
Man, somebody actually went and made a mod where you just launch one probe on a planet and it sucks every resource out.
That's amazing.
And if I ever replay the Mass Effect, I'm probably gonna find that mod. Storytelling that Bethesda is known
for. Aggressive creatures have been disrupting our experiments. Their habitat isn't far from here. If you could take care of them for us, we would...
Also, these don't sound like the same basic Bethesda voice actors, the same, like, 12 people that they use for projects.
Yeah, this is actually pretty flushed out.
Yeah. Wait. Yep, there he goes. I wonder how annoying that's gonna be with, like, all these people who have explosive packs.
Right.
Because, like, that's just been a constant thing in this presentation every time combat's on screen.
It's completely up to you.
To go boom. You want to interact with each I was waiting for the pack to blow up when he hit him.
And see what you can find. Harvest resources. God, it's a mushroom hippo dinosaur.
Or simply take in the views. With the help of your scanner, you'll chart the uncharted and discover exotic wildlife.
That lightning engine's pretty nice.
If you have this,
if that's actually how it's gonna look. Figure out that certain creatures. This is close enough to release, and I really hope this is how it's gonna look.
I would assume so. It's close enough that I don't think you're gonna get any changes.
Experience and rewards for fully surveying planets and fully surveying a whole system.
This is a next-gen exclusive, right?
Concepting these creatures, we really
yes, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, thank God. Okay.
We didn't want alien monsters.
In fact, this might be the first, like, big release that's next-gen exclusive.
So tired.
When it comes to our no, I'm pretty sure that FF16 is going to be on PS5 exclusive, so maybe that'll be first.
The game feel more filmic, to use lighting and color to really make it feel more cinematic.
Get him. Oh, he's kind of cute.
I'm like 10 seconds behind you, so I love the build up to then seeing worms coming out of its face.
Yeah, right. I don't know, he's kind of goofy looking. I like him.
After some exploring, you can find a spot to set up a base camp. Outposts can be built almost anywhere on any planet. And the habitat modules come in all shapes and sizes, filling all different purposes. You can even live in them. Assign crew and companions to work at your outpost.
This really is just Bethesda No Man's Sky, isn't it? To harvest
resources while you're... but no multiplayer, I don't think.
is we have a new flight cam where you can toggle
original No Man's Sky.
Or you can now use
Original No Man's Sky
camera, which helps plan out larger parts of the outpost and placing those larger halves, so that way you can really plan your structures and what the overall feel of your outpost is. And then when you're on your feet, you can really
do underwater outposts and water worlds
much easier.
Oh, that would be cool.
I loved trying to like jankily decorate my house in Fallout 3, so I'm all here for that.
Yeah, it's fair. Did you do any of the settlement building in 4?
Sadly, no. I didn't play around with it too much.
Yeah, I also kind of...
Because I hated how worn down and broken everything looked.
I mean, that's fair. Or already have.
Mod your weapons to adapt them to your playstyle. Different weapon sights and scopes, larger magazines, a selection of grips and barrels.
I appreciate this. This looks like a very big and ambitious game, even for Bethesda standards.
Yeah.
All you stealth players out there will surely need a suppressor.
It's not what suppressors do, it's not how they work.
Also choose to go hands-on with melee weapons.
I think it's always a delicate balance between like what's realistic, what's sim, and what's Hollywood. And I think we sort of err on the side of like what's fun for the player.
With Starfield, we've completely overhauled our combat. It's more dynamic, the animations are more fluid. It just feels great.
We probably have more mods and more weapons in this game than I want to say any other game we've done before. There's a lot of variety.
Grenade launcher? Sick.
One of the many factors to pay attention to when engaging in combat. You may need to switch things up based on your environment.
Ooh, thermal scope.
Gravity is different for each planet, and boost packs are excellent for getting around.
Okay, so no bullet draw. Which I guess makes sense, because then you'd have to worry about different planets' gravity.
Yeah, that would be weird.
Sometimes you'll even feel like you're flying.
That would be probably damn near impossible, even for them. Challenge. Even for the current hardware.
Actually push you backwards. Energy weapons, on the other hand, offer a more stable shooting experience.
We also have mag weapons. These are high-powered electromagnetic induction ballistic arrays. Each barrel has its own targeting laser and can dish out some serious damage. Whether you want to get up close and personal with your own two fists, or you like more
punch that thing in the face.
Submachine guns.
Fuck that guy.
Or something bigger. Starfield's got you covered.
I like the weird little compact minigun.
Right.
Kind of a neat design.
That weapon wheel is massive. That's awesome.
Yeah. Everything I'm seeing so far, it looks like enemies aren't really spongy, but I don't know how that's going to continue once the actual game releases.
Yeah, I like the difficulty balance of instead of making the enemies have more health, make them hit harder almost.
Yeah.
Like, just like scale it up, you have less health and the enemies are... Everyone has the same health and just hit harder across the board on both sides.
Yeah. Yahoo! They really love showing off that jetpack explosion tech.
Hey, Maui, don't chew the...
Oh boy, the Force!
Thanks again for being with us today. We are just so grateful that you've taken the time and spent it here. I know there was probably a lot to take in. There's a lot to the game, even more than...
I'm curious how they're going to play the antagonist in this game. If there's going to be, like, a face for a specific villain, or if it's just going to be trying to find the mystery in all the factions that get in your way.
It feels like it's going to be more, you know, find the mystery and then some dudes might get in your way.
Putting something special of themselves into it. So let's hear some of their favorite moments.
I love the way that our final combination of all the new tech has come together to create some of the most beautiful sunsets and sunrises we've ever had in any of our games.
I love the creatures, the exploration, every biome is different. The word that comes to mind is vast.
I like to use our photo mode to...
Oh, hey, there's that weird little space station that they had from the trailer, teaser trailer.
Wow, I can't believe that there's more.
I was going to say, that hasn't shown up at all in this until that one little screenshot, really.
My favorite part is every time you step out on a planet, it's a unique experience.
You spend all this time building your ship, and you see it on the landing pad. These things are gigantic. It's the kind of thing that you just can't get anywhere else.
There's something about seeing a tower over in the distance and going, I know the gravity's low here. I think I can make that jump.
My favorite part is biomes, spaceships,
audio design,
planets,
the day-night cycle.
Those details matter to me.
Diplomacy, exploration,
freedom,
the ending.
Vesca. Obviously.
I love the robot so much.
The incredible amount of worlds we created.
Sniper rifles, come on.
Lever action, rocket launcher,
brain sprout.
I love, but some people might find creepy. I don't know. And what's right, Ben?
The thing that I enjoy most about the game is the freedom to be who you want to be.
Big robot running through your beach day.
It's what you come to expect from a Bethesda title, but on a much bigger scale.
I love that sort of goofiness.
On behalf of all of us, we can't wait for you to play Starfield and make your own special moments.
There it is. The Field Star. Watch them have a one last thing after the Starfield Direct.
Could you imagine?
Yeah.
I don't think we had any, like, really surprising reveals.
I feel like that Persona 3 remake would have been if it hadn't just straight up leaked. Honestly, that Project Reef Fantasy, if you actually remember it, is pretty fucking huge. That coming out. But, like, there was a lot of stuff they just didn't, you know... didn't have much for it. Like Fable. Fable was entirely CG little thing.
Which, like, that was how they revealed it, like, what, 3 years ago at this point? How many times can you do that?
Yeah.
I'm so sick and tired of games being revealed, like, 6 years before they come out.
Yeah. Bethesda. I'm sorry to rag on Bethesda, but that's, like, an actual thing. Starfield is coming out 5 years after it was announced. It's been 5 years, and we haven't seen anything else from Elder Scrolls 6.
Yeah. That was a terrible decision to reveal that so soon.
Yeah. So that's probably at least another 2 years out, I'd bet.
Well, that was fun, though.
Yeah.
Better than the PlayStation one. And I had fun with
that. I would say so.
I am gonna pop off.
I'm probably gonna pop off here soon, right after the sizzle reel's over.
Farewell.
Have a good one, Luke.
You too.
Alrighty. So yeah, that was Xbox. That was pretty alright. That was a pretty alright little presentation that they had. I like how they're listing all the stuff. Oh, that's right, there was Like a Dragon... I think that's 8. I think that's supposed to be Like a Dragon 8. Yeah, and the Persona... I like how they had the Persona 3 remake there at the end, because they knew. They knew that that's kind of a big deal. Alrighty, well... yeah, Xbox... doing good. Starfield... honestly, I have a better impression of it now than I did when they showed that gameplay last year. It looks to me like they've you know, maybe changed up some of the animation flow and some of the combat from last year when they showed things off. So I'm actually quite happy that they decided that they were going to push this game a year and get the polish in there. So maybe it will be actually a lot better. So, yeah. I think that about covers my feelings. I'm still, like, trying to decide whether I want to do Persona 3 Remake, or I actually got my PlayStation 3 running in a state where I can record it and stream it. So I could just play FES, but I don't want to play a 100-hour game twice. So I'm just going to sit and twiddle my thumbs, I guess. But yeah, so thanks. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed what you saw here today, why not leave a follow here on Twitch, and then go follow me in my Twitter and sub to my YouTube. All that stuff's down in the About section on my Twitch here. And if you want to see any of my previous streams and like the previous gaming news stuff, like the PlayStation event that happened last month or Summer Game Fest that happened a couple days ago, that stuff is going to be up on my archive channel. So yeah, go check that out as well. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye bye.